My name is Gbenga Adebayo. I'm a doctor. I'm from Nigeria. I love to teach. That's me. I came here hoping to learn new skills, new tools that can make me more effective as a public health practitioner. And those expectations have been met. Yeah, this was my first time. Getting here, I didn't expect it to be as cold as the weather came to be. Although I'm coming to the Middle East, it's going to be warm, no need to fret, but it came very, very, very cold. And then coming to the Holy Land, I expected to come and see people, pious and all that, but getting to the airport, I saw somebody in full regalia of an Orthodox Jew, and was really smoking and looked very young. That to me was very jarring. So it set the tone for me to know that, well, it's the Holy Land, but not everything is holy. Dorm life was very fine. I had great roommates. Not beyond just my room, we had a lot of fantastic people living in dorms. It was fun having parties, meet-togethers, get-togethers in the different apartments. I thoroughly enjoyed it. I think it's one of the best programs I can imagine in the world. I think I greatly enjoy the courses. I've had friends that have been in other top schools in court, and they told me that comparing this program and that the other one in other top schools, I think this one was good, and I found it to be so for me. I've learned a lot of new skills that I think will make me very effective when I go back home. The trips were very, very interesting. It was not just learning, it was not just going to class. We also had the opportunity to go around and tour around Elath, the North, the Sea of Galilee, all the different parts of Israel. I greatly enjoyed them. And of course, this year also, God blessed me with a new baby. And that's, although I wasn't there, but it was great. Not really. I can't say that. I took ill during one of the trips. That was not so cool. But got better, got stronger, and this trip was still fun. Thank God. If I had to choose one, because there are many issues facing the world right now, you can count so many. If I had to choose one, I like to say it's the evidence. How do we gather evidence, publish evidence, create evidence? What is even evidence? What evidence-based medicine? What's evidence-based public health? I think those are key issues that we need to affect, because all this gathering of evidence and sorting of evidence and the politics that go with it, I think it cuts across every public health issue that we have to deal there with. We need to take care of that. That's a difficult one. I've learned a little bit more about myself. I've seen myself. It's been many years since I was in a student environment. It was fun doing that. And then getting to also fellowship with other believers from all over the world, that was very, very special. I greatly enjoyed it. And to know that there's one God, that different people in different countries, we serve Him, and we can all worship Him together. I really enjoyed that. That was cool. I missed my wife and my kids. I missed my family. That's about the only thing I think I really miss. And of course, I missed my company, running my business, being here for 1 year and not being able to teach. Although the things I love to do, my radio, my program, my TV show, I missed that. Go back to what I've been doing. Hopefully, doing much better. Go back to teaching, running the company I run, and doing a few other things, you'll find out about them with time. Well, hopefully I'll be a grandfather. I my I'll be a, I hope to be involved in raising new workforce in public health in Nigeria. I hope to be able to be involved in the School of Public Health one way or the other. I hope to still be a minister of the gospel, serving the Lord, if Jesus tarries, all this and more, I hope to have done. Life is short, it's not so long. Do what you can, when you can. Impact the people around you, solve the problems of people around you. And when all is said and done, fear God, keep his commandments. This is the whole duty of man.